right, my chef here says that we're making a menu which should take 3 hours, and we're going to do it in about 3 minutes. Yep. So bear with us. Tom Puskarich from Z, located right on Elm Street, joins us. And you're making a special chicken dish that's going to be on your fall menu.
Yes, we're rolling out our new fall menu about in about 2 weeks. October 15th is the date here. And this is a braised chicken with some figs and butternut squash. And we're going to run through it in about 3 minutes here.
Okay.
And see where we go.
All right.
So to start with it, I've taken some a whole chicken. Actually, these are just a chicken breast and a dredge in flour, browned up and seared. And once you brown them up and sear them, you're going to move them over into your pan. Now, braising is simply sear and then cook with water or stock. So once they're seared, you're simply going to add some chicken stock. Now, this is chicken stock and figs. And we're going to cover this.
And get some squash in there as well?
I have some squash in here, too. I sort of jumped the gun here to get it in here. The squash wouldn't squash wouldn't necessarily go in this stage.
It would get too mushy.
It would get too mushy over time. So you would simply then cover this in a casserole dish. I got my fancy-dancy industrial pan. It'd go into the oven for about half hour, 45
covered?
Minutes. Covered, uncovered. I've done it both ways, and I've yet to see a real big difference in it. But the big key is when you take it out, you want it to be about 3/4 of the way done, and then you're going to let it rest in the chicken stock. You're going to set it on the counter and let that cool. That'll keep the chicken nice and moist. If you were to take the chicken out right away, then the chicken has a tendency to dry out. Once it's cool, you're going to pull the chicken out, and then we're going to pick it. And, you know, we're just going to pick the chicken here. And then I'm just going to go right in an assembly. So what I have here is picked chicken. You know, put some picked chicken, and then again back in with some of the chicken stock. This is where the figs and where the butternut squash was come in handy here. We get some of the figs in there too. We simply heat this up. You simply heat this up and bring this back up to temperature. Now on plating, you could throw at this point, if you're doing this at home, you want to do a big family style, you could go in and throw the potatoes in. We're going to do this little restaurant style plating here.
I have some
roasted fingerling potatoes.
That goes on top.
Pour it all over it. We got it garnished. I got some garnish here with some pickled onions and then a little drizzle of pumpkin seed pesto, which is simply pumpkin seeds, oil, garlic.
And that
looks
beautiful.
Fall dish, nice and warm and toasty on these cool days that are coming for us.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Tom from Z. Appreciate it. We'll be right back.
Thank you.